Hello, everybody. Once again, Chris Blair coming to you from the LSU Sports Radio Network studios as we look back at LSU's incredible success in Omaha in the College World Series. By the spring of 1997, LSU baseball was already among the top programs in all of college baseball, with national titles in 91, 93, and 96. Now, getting to Omaha is tough. Winning in Omaha is even tougher. Winning back-to-back titles, well, that's elite. On June 7, 1997, LSU solidified its Team of the 90s status by defeating Alabama 13-6 in the College World Series championship game in Omaha's Rosenblatt Stadium. Coach Skip Bertman directed LSU to its fourth NCAA championship of the 90s, and he became just the second coach to win four CWS titles. In the College World Series championship contest, the Tigers exploded to a 9-0 lead after two innings and never looked back. Reliever Doug Thompson struck out the final Alabama hitter as LSU became the first school to win back-to-back titles since Stanford in 1987 and 88. Prior to the final versus Alabama, the Tigers posted a CWS opening victory over Rice and two dominating wins over Stanford. LSU belted 7 doubles and 10 home runs in the series and averaged better than 10 runs per game. The championship game completed a 57-13 campaign for the Tigers, who also won the SEC regular season title and established the league record for most victories in a season. After claiming the SEC title, LSU played host to the NCAA South Regional, where the Tigers, after suffering a third-round loss to South Alabama, battled back to claim their College World Series berth. LSU posted a thrilling 14-7, 11-inning victory over Long Beach State in a regional elimination game to force a rematch with South Alabama. Needing two victories, the Tigers launched 8 homers and a doubleheader sweep on the way to the regional title. Third baseman Trey McClure was named the regional's most outstanding player as he hit .435 with 5 doubles and 10 runs batted in. LSU completed the season with an NCAA record 188 home runs, breaking the previous mark of 161 homers set by Brigham Young in 1988. The Tigers homered at least once in all 70 of their games. All-American junior shortstop Brandon Larson enjoyed a remarkable season, batting .381 on the year, with SEC single-season records of 40 home runs, 118 RBI, and 250 total bases. Ace right-hander Patrick Coogan won 14 games and earned first-team All-America honors, while first baseman Eddie Furness collected 17 homers and 77 RBI and was a third-team All-American selection. Center fielder Mike Kerner.
Pretty well tagged. Left fielder going back at the warning track. He cannot get it.
And right fielder Tom Bernhardt combined to hit 39 home runs. And right-hander Doug Thompson recorded a remarkable 158 strikeouts on the year. The Team of the 90s had claimed 4 College World Series crowns in 7 seasons. Not since USC won 5 straight national titles in the 1970s was one school so dominant in the college baseball landscape. Back-to-back for LSU, bringing home their 4th national title in college baseball. We hope you've enjoyed this look back at the 1997 Road to Omaha and a national championship, all presented by our friends at LSU Online. Be back with you next time we take a look at the year 2000. Until then, this is Chris Blair. So long, everybody, and go Tigers!